You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Well, we'll be home in another hour. Probably 5 minutes later, we'll be fielding questions about our vanishing act. You ready for that?
Do we have a choice?
Yeah, we could turn right now and dance over the clouds of Rio before lunchtime. What do you say? Last chance.
You have been a really good friend to me. You know, nobody in my life has ever done what you did for me this week. Not the clothes and the trip. I mean, the way that you took care of me.
Well, it wasn't easy. You know, exactly what I'd call the helpless type.
Do you think that I'm worth all the trouble, even if we don't become more than good friends?
Hey, whatever happens, whichever way it goes, you're worth it.
Okay. As long as you're sure.
I'm sure. It's just one thing. The next move is yours.
Look who's here!
I'm... Hey.
Oh,
hi.
Oh, I missed you.
Are
so
you okay?
Much.
Oh. Yes, I feel good.
I missed you too. Welcome home.
Thank you.
Both of you.
Oh, Kurt, just pile everything over by the door while you get the rest, thanks.
If that's okay with you?
Oh, that's great.
What's all this stuff?
Wait till I show you. This man took incredible care of me.
I'm so glad to hear it. And you look so much better than you did when you were in the hospital.
Oh, I am. So how's everything here?
Great, thank you.
I'm hanging in.
Yeah.
Are you hungry? I'll go fix you something to eat.
Okay.
So does your presence, you mean, you're still separated from Ned?
We got a lot to work out.
Yeah, well, get to it and work it out. I'm cheering for you. I mean that.
Thanks.
Well, I'm sure you two have a lot to catch up on. Apparently, I've got 2 dozen urgent phone messages from Lucy Kerr, but I can't see what that's about.
Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, okay. Thank you for everything. Thank you. Bye.
So tell me what happened.
All right, Jax was so determined to take me away for some rest and relaxation, so he kidnapped me. We had so much fun.
Tell me.
Okay. We stayed in this amazing house on the beach in Malibu. And, excuse me, he bought me a whole new wardrobe.
This is so cute.
Insane. We saw everything. We went to Beverly Hills. We went all over Hollywood. We saw Mulholland Drive. We went for walks on the beach, and that was really good.
So? Well, what's the punchline?
Well, there is no punchline. But don't you dare say that to anyone. If anyone asks you, you say, I had an incredibly romantic holiday.
Incredibly romantic.
Very
sure,
good.
But, you know, I saw the way he looked at you when he walked in. And, you know, something's changed.
Yeah. Well, you know what? We've become best friends. Really?
Well, is that what he says?
That is what I say, and he's totally okay with it.
Okay. Whatever works. Did I happen to mention that I missed you so much? I mean, I missed you so much, you don't even understand. I was about to show up at your doorstep. I don't care where you were. I would have been there. And I'm not even kidding.
Yeah. I can see that. What happened while I was away?
Welcome home, Brenda.
Hi, Ned. Look at this.
These are for you.
These are for me? Thank you very much, Ned. They're very beautiful. I guess we better take those bags up, huh? I'm just going to show him, and I'll come back down a little bit. Okay?
Thank you. Sorry. I thought I was going to come down here and find you on his lap.
Not even close.
No progress at all?
I don't know what to do, you know. He said that, we can't make any progress with me here and him at the gatehouse. But I just can't waltz back in there as if nothing ever happened.
Well, maybe you could go in and just set some ground rules.
Yeah, but would he follow them when things got rough? Don't you see, I can't get past the fact that he lied to me. He made me feel like there was a part of himself, a part of his life that I could never try, that I could never touch. But if that's true, I mean, what, do I just accept it? What if I can't?
I think this may all come down to whether or not you think you can live without him.
I know this, I cannot live. The Quartermain code of honor. Not once more. No matter how much I love Ned, I cannot make lies and manipulation a normal part of my life, you know, especially now.
Why especially now?
Oh, God. Oh. Are you ready for this one? I think I'm pregnant.
Oh. You're having a baby? That's so great. That's so wonderful, isn't it? I mean, you're happy, right?
Well, it's something I've looked forward to my whole life.
Oh, look, and now it's real. How long has this been going on? I mean, how long have you guys been trying?
Oh, no, it wasn't like an issue yet, you know? I mean, we both knew that we wanted to have kids. We just figured, we'd let nature take its course. I mean, my mom always used to tell me that when my time came, I'd be a fertile myrtle.
Right, listen, you know what this means? It means I'm going to be an aunt. Aunt Brenda! Okay, how long? I mean, how many months are you? Or have you gone to see a doctor yet? Because that's really important. Ned must be so happy. You haven't told Ned? I understand why you haven't told him so far. I know things are really tense between you two, but...
Brenda, intense. We live in separate residences.
I know, but look at this. Don't you feel like it's the perfect reason for you two to get back together?
I think it is the best possible thing that could happen at the worst possible time.
Oh, listen to me. I'm your best friend, and I'm going to support you no matter what you do. But I have to tell you that it's wrong not to tell Ned right now, because you are doing the exact thing that you were accusing him of doing. You are keeping secrets, and you're shutting them out. I really know in my heart that you two can work this out. I do. Look at everything you've been through already.
I have. You know something? It's been over all the same issues. Ned's lying and protecting his family.
Oh, and you're being stubborn.
Stubborn? Oh, boy. You know what? If you really believe that, then I feel more alone now than I ever did.
I'm sorry. I just meant that you guys both have very strong points of view. And you're proud. But you have someone else to think about now. You know, you have a whole new person.
Yeah, who's going to be my responsibility?
Yours and Ned's. Whether you guys are together or not. Listen, Ned has the right to know that he's going to be a father. I think you should just go tell him and move on from there.
Yeah, and just hope that the rest of it goes away, you know? God, I can't.
You can't?
No, I can't do this right now. I got to think one more, okay? Just please, I got to go.
Please.
Hi.
Hi.
Bad news?
Oh, I don't know. I hope not.
Okay, look. There isn't any doubt about ours. It is absolutely horrible.
Well, don't worry. No one's died or injured.
How can you even say that?
You guys, please, just tell me what's going on.
Deception's been solved.
Well, yeah, I thought that was the whole...
Katherine Bell.
And you are the only person who can help me at this point.
Help you what?
You have to refuse to be the face of deception from now on. Thank you. Okay, so don't you think you at least owe me that much?
I owe you the loss of my job?
Well, I did give you that job in the first place. Well, sort of. The point is, you are not losing your job. You're just going to be leaving your job. We get to hit Katherine, and this will definitely help your career.
Help my career how?
Well, instead of being the face of deception, you are going to get to be the face of Jack's Cosmetics. This will give you so much more exposure and so much more recognizability.
How about more money? Well, I mean, deception pays me very well.
Well, I'll be happy to more than match any offer you've got. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Well, why not? And this is the perfect time because my contract is almost up. And you know what I'm going to do? I am going to make Katherine squirm, just like she tried to do to me in the beginning. And then at the very last second, I'm just going to drop this on her.
Yes. A woman after my own heart.
Yes, this has all kinds of advantages.
Sure does. For everybody except poor, pitiful little Kathy. Listen, we have a few more business things to discuss, so if you'll just excuse us.
Dinner at the Outback later, is all right?
Of course.
I'm back. Hey, did you miss me?
Hey.
Of course, every day. Hey, so how was L.A.?
Oh, my God, it was so cool. In fact, it could not have been any more perfect. There was no earthquakes, no mudslides, just 3 days of beautiful sunshine and being spoiled. In fact, my tour guide here took indulgence to new heights.
I'm glad to see you made it back in one piece. You're still recuperating, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, but I took very good care of myself, didn't I?
I can vouch for it.
I love this new look, Max. What happened to you?
I'm experimenting. I want to know if there's any truth to the rumor that clothes make the man. Or if integrity comes from within.
Well, it's nice to see you again, too, Mac.
I'm so sorry. I just realized you two haven't even met. Jax, this is one of my very best friends in the whole world, Robin Scorpio.
Hi.
Hi, Robin. It's a pleasure meeting you. Brenda's told me wonderful things about you.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. I've been looking forward to meeting you.
And guess what? This is...
It probably won't be such a pleasure meeting me. I'm Katherine Bell, the woman who took deception out from underneath you.
So, you're the one who ousted Lucy Coe, huh?
I am indeed. I am going to be the biggest rival that Jax Cosmetics has ever known. Maybe deception will become so powerful, I'll buy you out, too.
Be my guest. I thrive on competition.
And he doesn't care who he plows over in the process. Isn't that right?
So, now, I can tell you're an incredibly crafty businesswoman.
Really? How?
A certain glint in the eye. Something nice and cold and steely.
Thank you.
I'll remember to keep my guard up when you're around.
I'll do the same.
Would you guys like me to show you to your table?
That's such a good idea. I was just about to suggest that.
Bye. Right over here.
Ahem. She's not as interesting as you might think.
Huh?
No, she's very obvious. She's just blind ambition. That woman will go after anything she wants, and she'll do anything she can to get it. So if I were you, I wouldn't be fooled by her sweet little smile. She's probably just as competitive as you are.
Well, if things work out the way I hope, Katherine will find herself pitted against Lucy Coe, not me.
Do you really think that Lucy Coe would trade her ELQ stock for Jax Cosmetics?
I have a hunch.
Well, I wouldn't let Ned know about that hunch if I were you.
Of course not. Better put an end to the deal before it even got underway.
So you're just willing to sit here and talk to me about this, knowing that I'm really good friends with him?
Well, you're my friend too. I trust you. That's so hard to believe?
No. I guess I'm just not used to it.
You know, I find it curious.
You're in a relationship with a man who didn't trust you and refused to confide in you, yet you're incredibly eager to win him back.
Well, Sonny and I are just meant to be together. Like, I don't know how to explain it, you know? Sometimes love just doesn't make sense. Hey, so why don't you tell me about this hunch? Because I don't know if you're aware of this, but Lucy Coe guards that ELQ stock with her life.
Well, from what I'm learning, making Edward as miserable as she possibly can and getting revenge on Katherine at the same time are of equal importance.
Wow, you've really done your homework. What, did some CIA agent put out a dossier on Lucy's personality?
Well, you can't win the game unless you have an intimate knowledge of the other players.
Okay, so if you're so sure that you know what's in this for Lucy, what's in it for you?
What else? 10%.
Are you serious? That's what you've been after this whole time?
Well, I wouldn't mind owning a piece of ELQ, wouldn't you?
Ned was right this whole time. We were the ones who told him he was being paranoid. You are so... Does this mean you're going to be staying in Port Charles?
Right now, my only plan is to make no plans.